Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise 1.21 of the textbook, First Course in Probability. So in this problem, the goal is to find the total number of paths going from a point A to a point B on a two-dimensional grid if you can only move either right or up. So in the slide here, you don't have the picture, but I'm going to show you on the board what it looks like. So basically, you have a grid that looks like this. So that's a 4x3 grid. So something like this. Then you have point A at the bottom left and point B here at the top right. And the goal is to count the total number of possible paths going from A to B, but you are only allowed to move right or move up. And so one possible motivation for that would be, for instance, let's assume that this grid is in fact a straight network and you are at point A and you want to drive to point B, and obviously to do this as fast as possible, you don't want to go in the wrong direction, and so you can only go either east or north on the map. And so again, the question is to find the total number of possible paths going from A to B. So number of paths going from A to B. So in this case, and also we assume that we can only move right or up. So in this case, the idea is to observe that to go from A to B going only right or up, you need to move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times. So the idea is really to think of all the possible paths going from A to B as a sequence of 7 moves. And now, clearly, to go from A to B, you need to go 4 times to the right and 3 times up, okay? And so your number of like 7 moves is decomposed into 4 right plus 3 up. Now, the last step is really to observe that there is in fact a one-to-one correspondence between all the possible orderings of those 7 arrows, where you have 4 arrows going right and 3 arrows going up, and the set of paths going from A to B. So indeed, so if you fix a specific sequence, so let's say right, up, right, right, up, up, right, okay, this sequence, so you have indeed 1, 2, 3, 4 arrows going right, 3 arrows going up, then your corresponding path is going to be first a right move, so you go in this direction, and then you go up once, this one, and then you follow here, right again, and right again, and then up, up, and right. So that gives you, for instance, one possible path here. So you see, if I fix my sequence of arrows, that gives me one specific path. At the opposite, if I fix one specific path that's going to give me following those arrows, you see each time if you go east or north or right or up. And so indeed, there is a one-to-one correspondence between number of paths, between the set of paths, I should say, and the set of possible orderings of those 7 symbols. So from that, you can conclude that the number of possible paths is equal to the number of possible permutation of those symbols, okay? So eventually you end up with number of paths is equal to number of permutation of 3 right arrows and of 4 right arrows and 3 up arrows. That's an example of permutation with repetition, and we know already in this case that the total number of permutation is going to be equal to 7 factorial divided by 4 factorial times 3 factorial. What you can do also is just say that from the seven moves, you need to choose four of them where you are going to go right, and for the last three, you are going to go up. Or the other way around, you can say from the seven moves, I'm going to choose three of them to go up, and the other four will be pass going down, which tells you that the total number of permutations we are looking for, that's also equal to the number of paths going from A to B if you only move right or up, is going to be equal to, well, 7 choose 4, but that's also equal to 7 choose 3. And if you expand those two numbers, you get the symmetry that's equal to 7 factorial divided by 4 factorial times 3 factorial. So that's your total number of paths going from A to B. If you use a calculator, or you can even do that by hand, you would find that the total number of paths here is equal to 35. That's the final answer. There are 35 possible paths going from A to B on this two-dimensional grid if you can only move right or up.